I've seen a few people online talking about a strange photo online. Something called Glowjaw. It's a low-res photo of a darkened room on the right side of which there's a humanoid thing, for lack of a better term. The thing looks like a person wearing a black bodysuit, covering its entire body. There seems to be a mask of some kind donned on the thing's face. It has two massive black holes for eyes, a little bulge for a nose, and a glowing white mouth. Hence the name, Glowjaw. Now, I've seen people claim it's an artistic image or a meme. Someone went as far as to say that it's a haunting image of some kind. I can say for certain, that whatever this thing is, whatever this image is, it's a photograph. I am saying this with the utmost certainty because I've seen that freakish thing staring at me through my webcam. Glowjaw is a real thing, I don't know if it's some sick guy. One who's getting kicks out of scaring the living crap out of people or something else, but this thing, this creature, it's very real. And when it creeps on you from nowhere, and suddenly stares at you with its gaping maw, it's unpleasant, to say the least. 2 years ago, I came from work one evening. I get to my room and I hear the sound of a Skype call ringing through my computer speakers. I turn on my screen and I see that a buddy of mine, Evan, is calling me. Moreover, I see that there are 96 missed calls from Evan. That was strange, to say the least. I turn off the call and message Evan that he shouldn't have called me 96 times and that I'll call him after I take a shower. Once my message came through, the chat showed Evan typing something before stopping. I didn't think much of it and started changing. Another call. Evan called me again. I turn down the call and message him again. Dude, I'll talk to you in a few. God, chill bro. Evan was always a little weird, but he wasn't ever nagging or anything. Just kind of awkward and a tad morbid. He wasn't harmful in any way, but he'd always talk about the darkest, brooding, and borderline vile stuff. A text message came from Evan, a simple one-worded text, okay. The tiredness of work started catching up to me, so I stood there for a moment, staring into the screen completely lost in my own head. As I'm about to head to the shower, I heard the oh-so-familiar ring of a Skype call. A switch flipped in my head, my vision dimmed and I felt the blood rush to my head. The jerk was being a pest and I was going to give him a piece of my mind. I answered the call and I was greeted by the blue-tinted wall of Evan's room. His webcam was always awful. He never bothered getting a new one because he liked it for his own strange reasons. His webcam turned the image dark blue and the pixels were noticeable. The screaming of a Swedish black metal musician was audible in the background. Evan wasn't in the view, however. That and the obnoxious music made me even angrier and I started cursing out at the man. I was so pissed it took me about 3 minutes to realize I was talking to a literal wall on the other end of the call. Once I did realize I was talking to myself, my anger started dissipating and turned to confusion. I called out Evan's name, but no response came. I tried calling him a few more times but no one answered. In the meantime, the song in the background ended. Once the other end of the call turned dead silent, I saw movement at the far right side of the screen. Something very subtle. I sat down and called Evan's name again. Still no answer, I was staring at the wall. I was going to shut down the call and block the guy for being a nuisance, but something knocked Evan's webcam down. It landed lens down on the floor. I told him to cut the crap and threatened to stop talking to him if he didn't.
I'm sorry.
Came through the other side of the video call. It wasn't Evan's voice though, it was way too high-pitched to be his voice. This guy was a massive tank of a man, nearly 2 meters tall. Probably 120 kilos in weight and he sounded like a caveman would. Evan. I called out again, as his webcam shook around for a bit. It turned around and I nearly fell from my chair. I was so surprised by what was looking at me that I swiped at my own webcam, knocking it to the ground, breaking it. We've made eye contact for about half a second but I'll never forget that shape. Black bodysuit. A bluish mask. Two massive holes for eyes. A glowing white mouth. The face of pure evil, I felt it sucking the life out of me. The call ended once my webcam landed and broke into on the floor. I grabbed my phone and started calling Evan. Being both pissed and confused, what the hell was that? I kept trying about what I had seen all the while trying to call the guy, he never picked up the phone. I ended up going to his place, but he never opened the door either. Eventually, I called the cops when one of the neighbors told me nobody had seen him for over a day. It turned out Evan was dead once the cops broke in. The cause of death was determined to be a sudden cardiac arrest. There were no signs of forced entry or anything like that. Evan's death was ruled as one of those things that just happen. Moreover, it seems like he's been dead since the morning of that day. His face was cracked open when he fell down, hitting his head on the edge of his desk. His eyes were still wide with terror when we found him. Strangest of all, his laptop was running with the Skype chat with me open. I didn't really tell anyone about the Glowjaw thing because who would have believed me? I'd be called insane. I was supposedly having a Skype chat with a man who had been dead for hours and saw a crazy monster staring at me from his webcam. Right. I am talking about this now because I keep seeing Glowjaw's photo pop up in various places online. Whatever this thing is, I doubt its growing presence is a good thing.